What does family mean to us all? To some, family is merely a shared name. A lineage that goes back to the beginning of time, a commonality of principles, thoughts, likeness, or beliefs. The only thing common in our family is our love for one another. Bonds which have been tested throughout the years, at times damaged and bruised, pushed to their limits, but never broken and never abandoned. Unfortunately, we don't always get to be with one another as often as we would like. But when we do get together, we go hard. We drink, we dance, we pick at one another, and we drink some more. Well, except for Raquel. But it's all in the name of love. All in the name of the family. Novoa. Not Nova or Nueva or Nova Scotia. Novoa. Ask anyone about the Novoas. I bet you they'll have a few stories to tell you. And do we fight? If you knew my family, you would laugh at the question. Because we always fight. And we fight hard. But no matter how hard we fight, whether physically or emotionally, we never turn our backs on one another. We always hold each other accountable. And yes, we differ individually, but no matter what we do it right, and we make it memorable. Because Novoas have courage and are never afraid to take a chance. I think that's something our father instilled in us. He taught us to work hard. And no matter what, to take care of your family. Look out for your brothers. Look out for your sister. Love your mother. And please, hijito, stop hitting your father. The older we get, the more we realize how lucky we are. We often take that for granted. The strength of our family. Because not everyone has what we have. And I realize that more and more each day. We didn't get to choose our family, but we choose to be a family.
Thank you. going golfing in the morning, Rob?
Is that the boots that were used to be mine?
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, still alive.
The ones you gave him for our wedding?
I only wear them when I come here.
That's a solid boots, though.
I think they're Justin's.
Yeah. Guillermo's moving to Kentucky. Now, Rob, you just need to move here, too. Raise your kid in the bed.
Don't worry, Guillermo. We'll do it all.
Bitch, you just got here.
What's he been doing? Holding the camera the whole time?
He was taking pictures out of the tree stand.
His fat ass can't get up there.
Fucking George of the Jungle.
Stop on all that.
Look at his ass.
Oh, damn it.
I think it's pretty solid. Is that tree? There you go, bro.
Alright, move the truck, give me the saw.
Just sit on that fucking big branch, you dumbass.
Here's big the branch. That's cut. The one I'm cutting off.
No.
Yeah. Why?
You're gonna cut it right there? You better move the truck.
I'm going to.
My back fucking hurts.
I just put that fucking new
tape. I ended up doing the stabilizer bar when I was here.
I wasn't driving it then.
Uh-huh.
I was driving my van then.
Yeah.
Where's the van now?
And my yard broke down.
What's it in?
No. It needs a bunch of solenoids and it costs like $400 to $600.
We'll take one more picture, Mia. All right, just hold those positions. Don't move.
Once I get in position, we're gonna hold that position for about 6 seconds.
Just give me a still shot. Just look straight at the camera. All right, here's a long 6 seconds. Yeah. Thank you.
to the square. There's a big open void in between two buildings. And the one closest to McDonald's caught fire from electrical and burnt the second building next to it and stopped with a firewall. We had 6 or 7 different departments there, 2 ladder trucks, and we spent almost 28 and a half hours there. Went in 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and was there to the next day. And there were 2 of us that stayed the full time from the beginning to the end. That was me and my buddy Chase. Which, I mean, it was a total loss, but we saved the rest of the square. Besides the 2 that caught it.
And what was that? You said you got an award for that?
Yeah, we got certificates from the House or the Senate, and we got some recommendation letters, and we got all kinds of stuff for it. People brought us, like McDonald's brought us burgers and coffee and everything. Sonic was bringing us food while we were there. People were just bringing cases of sodas and water. It was pretty neat. I mean, the whole community came together. It was intense though. Like when it was happening, there was probably like 600 people piled up on the square just watching. It was all over the news. And then, like, that's what Brittany found out. Somebody took a picture of me walking towards the building in my gear with no mask on. And sent it to Brittany. So she freaked out. We thought she was going to go into labor. The videos are still on YouTube about it. It was pretty cool. It was an adventure for sure. Especially my first fire. That was the first burning structure that I ever got to go into. I was still in fire academy when it happened. We got to get on top of it and cut holes in the roof for ventilation. We got to play on the ladder truck for the first time. It was crazy. I mean, to stay up for the full 28 hours, whatever it was.
That, probably that adrenaline.
Yeah. I mean, it was a blast.
Where was Papa and your mom? Did they go down there?
No, they probably sat at home. I don't even know where they were.
Did they know you were down at the fire?
Yeah. After a little while, I got to call everybody and let them know that, you know, what was going on. I think Papa and Mom came down the next morning and seen me. And they tried to get us to leave so we could go take showers.
Our valedictorian, Raquel Novoa.
Hello, everyone. We're gathered here today to celebrate the last day of our high school career. We have been working 4 years for this moment, and finally, today is the day. Everyone, look around. Look at all of your friends sitting right here on this very field. Now think about this. This is our senior class. These are our people. Now, even if there are people in the class that you may have never talked to, you still know them. You see them every day. You have classes with them, and you see them in the cafeteria. Now think about another thing. This is the last day we will all be in one place together. This is the last day that some of us will see each other. After today, we go live our lives how we want them. And I know that some of you are thinking, this is it, I made it, and I'm out, and I'm never coming back. But one of the hardest things in life is saying goodbye for the last time, and for some of us, this is goodbye forever. It is the time to go our separate ways, and I, for one, am going to miss this. This is our day, so let's make the most of it. Let us celebrate the fact that we made it through Mr. Burks' history class. Whew, that was rough. Let's celebrate the fact that I formed a calculus club with the help of McKinley. Let's celebrate the fact that Miss Lewis won't have to deal with me not doing her homework, even when I knew she was going to give me one of her famous speeches. Let's celebrate the fact that Mr. Timpani won't have to deal with me and Garrison's 10-cent jokes anymore. And let's celebrate the fact that we survived. We made it. Through all the bad times, through all those moments when we thought, there is no way I'm going to pass that class. And trust me, we've all been there. We made it, and we made it together. I am so proud to say that I was part of the best senior class that anyone could ask for. I cannot express my gratitude to all of you and to the teachers that have helped me on this journey. Eleanor Roosevelt once said, "The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams." So class of 2017, let's make our futures beautiful and follow our dreams. Have the courage to achieve everything you want to in life. A wise man once told me, discipline, education, vegetables. Now, I don't know about the vegetables, but I do know that as we go on from now, we should keep learning and have the discipline in our lives to gain new knowledge and achieve every goal that we set out to achieve. Appreciate the little things in life. Hold on to all of your memories. Take pictures, go on adventures, and live your life to its fullest potential. You only live once, but if you do it right, once is enough. Don't worry about failures. Worry about chances you miss when you don't even try. I know we are all so happy to graduate, but let's be honest here, it's a little scary. From here on out, we decide our lives. We decide how it's going to change. We decide where and how we're going to live. Everything that happens after today is on us. Now, here's a quote from Grey's Anatomy that I kind of changed. Today is the day our lives begin. Today, we become citizens of the world. Today, we become grown-ups. Today, we become accountable to someone other than our parents. Accountable for more than just grades. Today, we become accountable to the world, to the future, to all the possibilities that life has to offer. Starting today, our job is to show up wide-eyed and willing and ready. For what? I don't know. For anything. For everything. To take on life, to take on love, to take on the responsibility and possibility. Be courageous. Starting today, open your book of life and begin to write your story. Today, my friends, our lives begin. And I, for one, cannot wait. Can you?
Feel about your baby girl graduating?
I'll tell you after the first beer.
Thank you. still does.
Send me your location. Let's focus on communicating. I just need a time and place to come through. Send me your location, let's focus on communicating, cause I just need the time and place to come through. Send me your location, let's ride the vibrations. I don't need nothing else but you. At times I wonder why I fool with you, but this is new to me. This is new to you. Initially I didn't wanna fall, but you gathered my attention. It was all for you. So don't take advantage, don't leave my heart damaged. I understand that things go a little bit better when you plan it. Oh, so won't you send me your location, let's focus on communicating, cause I just need the time and place to come through. Send me your location, let's ride the vibrations. I don't need nothing else but you. I don't wanna fall in love off of some sweet, so let's keep personal. I got a lot of cool spots that we can go. Tell me what. Thank you.